There is power in the name.
Be integrated the way you are seeing them. Others would say, I think no one advised me. I came out with nothing. It is the same with our Christian life today. Others have joined the Christian family way back as early as the 70s. Some of us even joined the various groups that were in. Some are in the WCF, some are in the MCF, and all sorts of groups that were in. And today, we can pose the question, what have we achieved? What have we achieved? Others would say, I've won a soul somewhere. Others would say, I gave someone who needed something. Others would say, I think I lost it along the way and I've done nothing. My understanding is that in our Christian life, we should reflect the way we live if we are truly God's children. But the case is opposite. Most of the injustices that we are seeing today, the moral decay and the evil doing that we are seeing today, are being done by us, the Christians, because we have forgotten our souls. We have forgotten who we are, and we have forgotten who we've been called to be. We have become a channel of destruction to many, but God called us so that we can be a channel to save His creation. Hence, our theme for the day, a new beginning in our Christian journey. May you take your neighbor and tell your neighbor, a new beginning in our Christian journey. Empire. We have read in two books, we've read in Isaiah chapter 43, verses 18 to 19, and we have seen the message that is coming to the Israelites through the prophet Jeremiah. God is trying to remind the Israelites, telling them that He is going to save them. In verse 18, we say, He's saying, remember not the former thing. By this, I'm sure He was trying to tell them to not to remember the pain that they had gone through. Everything that they were going through as they were slaves, because at this time they were under captive under the Babylonians. God is trying to tell them to live a life of not realizing or not thinking too much on the way they lived as slaves. He saved them from the Egyptians using the Red Sea. And He's trying to tell them that even this time, as I have saved you from the Egyptians, I'm going to save you. God was promising to make a way in the wilderness. He was promising to make rivers in the desert. I think it must have been impossible for the Israelites to imagine this. But knowing that God is a God who makes His promises to come true, they knew that He was going to do it. For He was able to pass the Red Sea. He was able to make the rivers even in the desert. He was trying to emphasize to them that they should forget about the pain. I think this came as a message of hope to the Israelites. When you look at 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17 and 18, this is a letter to the Corinthians. And this is Paul talking to the Corinthians, encouraging them that had given their lives to God, but still kept on clinging to their past life the way man had judged them. That you have given your lives to God and you are a new creation. Paul was educating these people to say, do not judge one another. uyayiphungula. Don't judge one another as the world judges you. Be confident that Jesus has reconciled you back to himself. God is trying to counsel them that had forgotten how God had saved them. He's trying to remind them that please be comforted that God has drawn you back to himself. He has forgotten about the old things that you used to do. You are a new creation. If you look at the city of Corinth, it was a cosmopolitan city. It was a city which had diverse cultures. Why do you sumba, wapete, ifintu, nabantu, abapsana psana? Imitundu icha psana psana. Abantu amaleto njoka icha psana psana ngalina. All the things were happening. Even the immoral things were happening. Achitale edina. Would say. Sionza chale chita. Ukushana, waleshana. But Paul still reminded the people to say, despite everything that is going on, despite even the confusion that you're living in, once you give your life to God, you're no longer the same. What lessons are we going to draw from this? What lesson are we going to draw from this? I think we have 3 points that we're going to look at this morning. That is going to encourage somebody. It's going to encourage you and I of how God reconciles us back to himself. And our first point is dealing with our Christian foundation. We are going to look at dealing with our Christian foundation. In dealing with our Christian foundation, I think we have to sit down and think, how did I join this Christian family? What motive did I have to join this Christian family? What was I thinking to join this Christian family? You are going to ask yourself, how did I join to be a WCF? How did I join to be a GP? How did I join to become an MCF? All of us have got reasons why to join these rooms. And our motivations differ. Some of us join due to evil thoughts. And others join with good intention. One would say, why has she mentioned bad thoughts? There are times when you join a group saying, I think I have Sarah Kukanda. I can enjoy more. I think I'm going to be a good Christian. The champion is not a good Christian. The church is not a good Christian. And different other reasons. Others join because they knew that I'm going to join the WCF group. Because I want to divide the world. Therefore, I have a son of a Shika. What I'm thinking of, what I'm thinking of for Yandy. I can't send you to change it. There are some people that are there. Ah, you should go in and open a meeting. But others will say, I'm doing so well, but I lost it along the way. I don't know, I just lost it along the way. But others lost it because somewhere, spoke a thing that has made them not to do their work according to the way they were called. When it comes to giving, wale mwana kwa teba pereshi. Awa tuwalale kakanshi, abantu wale ndanga. Wale nanda teine mpelecha, aiteiki nalale ka. But we have forgotten that we've been called for a service. We have forgotten that we've been called for a service. Others would say, I've joined the Christian family because God saved me and my family. inokukula bali kumwakita musingitsako bati nanguwalelo ngatiyesaka kwaba walelo chamoto cha nthu chamwene kachanyi chatati nake it just brings you to God and so I think there's a mighty God somewhere and I think I just have to join a family that is going to keep me realizing every day that there's a God somewhere. I need to join the Christian family. When you look at all these things and you question yourself, how was my foundation? How did I join the Christian family? How did I join the WCF? And you're going to say, I think I've lost it somewhere. When they say they didn't have something to help me, how in that you share your plan? I think I've spoken, some have even gone back and stayed home because their motive of doing what should be helped. But because they've not been helped, they've sat back, they've taken off their uniforms and they're saying, I think there's no reason I can be fellowshipping with these people. But if you realize and you think to say, God is speaking to me and he's saying, despite whatever has happened to you, if only you can come back to me, all the things, all the old things are gone and you are a new creation. He's ready to embrace us and reconcile us back to himself. Similarly, in another aspect of our lives, our marriage, in churches, abana twakwa. Some of us acquired our marriages in a way that sometimes when you sit and you tell yourself, oh my God, now that I've known you, God, I think this was not correct. But take a question. No, I'm excited about it. But I'm going to take it. But you come to realize that God is saying, whatever it is, if you come to me, I'm able to embrace you back. There are times when you think, how far can ever John come to? Yeah, why? And you say, Lord, I think I was ignorant. And in my ignorance, I'm coming to your throne and I'm saying, Lord, you who's able to reconcile me back to you, I am here. Forgive me and bring me back into your presence. Our Papa Kola, he came here and he took over Dr. Chani. nindu kutina kwa tako mwana. Kwa Dr. Chani na mwana, mwana manji, mwana isa. Chukua la mkosa. We are going to bring the child. Na mwishai chua upe kwa mwenezi. Mwalipe ya chichu mwana. Ichawa. The reason is that because sometimes, you know, we hide this except, I'm an expert profession, so. Kula wa isa, abandu, na wala, nimi umara. Because sabichi, wale wa mpulinso ni, na wako ulanda, na wei, chichi, kalipa, chichi, kalipa. No, they're not speaking out. Aya, taka, tsa, mpulinso, na tiyo kwe wado. It is the same with us. Kalipata wa chila kwa kupati, chichi, wana kwa kwa we are not in the state. So he has somewhere to start from. Speak, tell him. It's because of this. Because of that. That is why it's like this. And God is going to say, I am a God of a second chance. He's going to embrace us. He's not going to remember the pain or everything that you went through. But he's going to say, here, come, and I will consign you back to me. There are so many things that have made us to be who we are today because of our wrong foundation. And the devil keeps on reminding us. Nangumre chitefi, ibukcheni. Nangumre chitefi, ibukcheni. Get up one day and tell the devil that it is time for God to reconcile me back to him. Because I have realized that even if my sins were dark, he's able to make them white as snow. He's able to reconcile me back to himself. He's able to bring us back to himself. God is a God who loves us. And he's willing to set us free if only we give ourselves wholeheartedly to himself, and he's ready to bring, to embrace us back to him. And who are going to begin a new life. Our second point, as we look at our theme, a new beginning in our Christian journey, is it is not too late to experience the love of God. It is not too late to experience the love of God. The Bible says, John 3 verse 16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Many times we think and sit down, how can God love me out of everything that I've done? How can he appreciate me out of everything that I've done? But he's saying, whosoever believes in me shall not what? Shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Allow God to touch your life. Remove self-pity. Triumphal says such that we even fail to go before God wholeheartedly. Just tell God, here I am, forgive me for all the things that I've done, and embrace me back to you. Touch me, I know I have sinned against you, but he's a God of a second chance. He's able, I'm more than able to embrace you back to himself. The secret is simple. Let's confess our sins to the Lord. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us. How do you, Nango, to not play an example, you know the love of a parent restored there. Nangu mwana nika wala ala, wamisaka wale mwota, wala ina jumwana wandeni. If a man can cry for a thief, what more God? How much does he love you? But you're coming here, it's to please God alone. Our nature they take it because of Ananika and Tabante. Do you come to church because of Ananika? We come here because we know that one day we shall stand before God and face judgment. And He's going to ask us, what did you do? Is that the reason I'm going to say, I'm going to stay back because I think him when I'm not going to put a land in. He's not the owner of the church. We come and realize that God is a God who loves us. We come and go to the church. You find that when someone gives you a rose flower, the white teacher will be sure to tell a rose flower. Wow, I think I'm loved. When someone calls you, yeah, sure. What's that you doing? I'm going to phone you. I feel loved. That is the love that is going to, God is going to give you. And the love that God is going to give you is beyond that love that man gives. If only we are going to remove the self-pity within ourselves. If only to please man, but let's do things to please God, and God is able to love us more than man can do. A new beginning in our Christian journey. Our third point, make a decision to serve God. Make a decision to serve God. It is saying a decision. If you want to say, I walk the walk alone. But if you decide to say, I have decided that I'm going to walk for God, I have decided I'm going to work for God, He's definitely going to give you that strength. With the love that you have, with the love that He's going to give you, He's going to make sure that He gives you the confidence to wait for Him and to serve Him. He's going to remove the fear. He's going to put in the confidence that will make you serve Him wholeheartedly and earnestly. If you experience the love of God, you're able to spread the love out. Because in the decision to serve God, I think that I'm going to be able to do it. I think what I'm going to watch and design in my place is that I think my boss is going to be. So if you love God, you're going to serve Him wholeheartedly. I'm going to walk by church. When there is work to be done, we are going to do it because we love God. When there are things to be done, we are going to do them because we love God. Give your lives to God. Be ready to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. And our character should be able to preach this. There's no way I'm going to come to somebody and say, I think he to come with me. When your character is opposite, when the immoral things that are happening, you are part of them, how are you going to encourage somebody? You will not manage to do so, because there will be, and they will be able to tell you that as you are pointing at me, the other thing that is pointing at yourself. What do you prefer? Would I have something else? What's the episode 83? begin with our character. It should begin with our conduct. So that even as we are able to speak to somebody about the way we have to start this journey, they will say, indeed, this is a message that is coming from God. Because look at the person that is speaking. The person who is speaking it all. In serving God, we have to make ourselves available for the service. The past 4 weeks we've been learning to be equipped for service. We have to make ourselves available for the service. How are we going to make ourselves available? Every time there's something to do, we have to tell ourselves, I think let me be part of this. Because there's no way you're going to say I'm available, but each time you're called, you're saying, ah, wait, I think I'm going to say that. You're pushing that blessing to an extent. Be ready. Be positioned as women, the WCF. Be positioned so that even if there's work to be done, if there's a service to be done, you are ready to do the service. You want to come up with one of but I can't support the team with money. There are a lot of strikers in a team, huh? But in the number one in a baller, you find that he's standing, and the people on that team will position themselves to get the ball, and he's going to say, okay, but stay clever, I'm going to die. I think that one is not ready. I think let's make pass it on to. There are a lot of strikers. He can pass it on to anybody. But he sees that one who is ready to get the ball. He's seeing that one who is ready for the target. That is what God wants us to do. He wants us to position ourselves at the position where he's going to see us. What a woman at least to. What a woman at least to. But I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. We are never available. I think we've become too busy in this world. And we are never available for the service of God. But how then are we going to begin a journey if we are not making ourselves available? He wants to use us as instruments. We are ready to be used by God in all circumstances. You find that someone is being told,
Let us all be ready to start a new life in this Christian journey.